that you've played with and against?
Best player I've played with? I'll have to say Gary Charles, and I'd say two, because they were both very same. Gary Charles and Kev Donovan. They were probably the best two players because they were dead skillful and made my job a lot easier, and they did a lot of running for me. Even though I did a lot for them, they did a lot for me as well. So, and Kev scored a lot of goals, especially at Wembley when he got Grimsby Town support promoted. So I'd say them two.
Who is your best friend in football?
Best friend in football, it is Gary Charles. He actually still works with me now. I've known him for over 30 years. 30 years I've known him for, and we actually, because we finished Grimsby Town, we came to the college and we still work with each other now. Sorry, just about your question, my best player I played against was Rudolph. He used to play for Chelsea and Holland. He was there and AC Milan. He was the best player I played against.
Yeah. What did you hate the most about starting pre-season training?
Running. I used to hit Willsby Woods. In the Willsby Woods, we used to go around there and we used to have to run around that about six times. And used to be on the clock. And if you weren't on the clock, if you didn't get in on the time, you had to run it again. No footballer likes to do pre-season. You couldn't wait to get the footballs out and have a match or a practice match. No one likes to do the running.
Which manager did you learn from the most and why?
Right. The best manager that I probably worked under was Alan Buckley, because we had a lot of success with Alan. We got a lot of promotions, we got Wembley twice. But the most I probably learnt off was probably Lenny Lawrence, because he brought in all the sports science side of it, like the diets and what you need to eat and all different techniques of training. Where with Alan it was a bit more regimented, we knew what we were doing, he drilled it into us what we needed to do, where Lenny gave you a bit more freedom to play.
What did you miss the most about playing?
The popularity. You can soon be forgotten in football. When you come out of football, while you're playing it, all the fans know who you are, but you got to remember that there's every year there's some new fans come to the ground, or the fans get older and the younger ones come. So sometimes the younger ones probably won't know who you are, where the older ones will. So sometimes after football, you don't miss the much playing. It's the popularity of, being recognised.
Who are your top five right backs, past or present?
Best right backs. Cafu. Gary Neville was a good right back. I think Phil Neal used to play for England years ago. I'm going back a long time here. I think Grimsby Town had a decent one. I can't really remember really good right backs, because the right backs that I really know, the three of them, they played for a long, long time. There wasn't that many more than them. Alves, he used to play for Barcelona. He was a good right back, but again, he played a lot of games, you see. A lot of them played for years and years, so I'd say them four. I can't really remember five, so I'd say four.
What would you think you would have been if you weren't a footballer?
Two things. Probably a jockey, because I'm only small. And if I weren't a footballer, I'd probably be working in the supermarket doing shelves, because I didn't do enough schoolwork. So it's so important that you do your schoolwork, just in case you don't make it. If you don't make it, there's always something to fall back on, so make sure you do your schoolwork, okay?
Best right winger to have played in front of you for Grimsby?
I think I touched on it earlier. It's hard to say between Gary and Kev. They were probably the best two. They were very, like I said, they were very similar. I played with Gary for about 9 years, and I played with Kevin, I think it was six, seven seasons roundabout, but I think it might have been a little bit less. But with Kevin, we played at a higher level. With Gary, we played at the lower levels, but we come through together. So very, very same. It's because the shape of football we played, them two had the similarities, the way they style. And they're both good lads as well.
What is your favourite film and why?
Favourite film? Avatar. I like Avatar. That was good because my daughter likes it, and I like going to the pictures with my daughter and my son. So I like that. They like it the same as me.
Is there a game or moment in your career that sticks out the most, and why?
It was probably the miss when I played Chelsea at home, Blundell Park. We got to the fifth round in the FA Cup, and they had a great chance. Last minute it was to score the goal to knock them out, and I think it would have been the furthest that Grimsby ever got to. And I dragged it a little bit past the far post, should have gone in, beat the keeper, but I weren't recognised really scoring loads of goals, so it was a good chance, and I missed it. So I had to go to a replay down at Stamford Bridge, and we got beat 4-1, I think it was. So that one, and then I'd say the chance I had at Wembley to win it before Wayne Burnett got the winner. I had a good chance, and the keeper just tipped it round the post, so that would have been nice.
Will you ever write another book?
Yeah, I've got a few more stories. I don't know if it'll get published, but yeah, call it Hotels and Changing Rooms. And I think a few people would leave their, you know, leave the country if I did. So yeah, I've got plenty more stories, but I'll keep them ones quiet.
Who are your sporting inspirations?
I'd say years ago it used to be Brian Robson, who used to play for Man United, him and Kevin Keegan. But Brian Robson really, because he was quite loyal to Man United. He stayed there nearly the majority of his career. He's still there now, and he still loves the club. So my sort of history with Grimsby Town was very, very similar to Brian Robson's, even though it's a little bit different. So he was probably one of my heroes.
Was Tony Gallimore as naughty as people say?
Much worse. He was much worse. But Tony, he was ever so funny. But he always did anything in fun. He was never anything naughty or nasty. He was very, very funny. He used to come to training, a bit worse for wear, but he was possibly the best trainer that we had. He was always at the front for running, which people didn't think he was, but he was. And he was very, very funny in the changing room, and he was liked by all the players.
Best starting 11 you have played in?
Best starting 11, right. I will say Aidan Davison, me, Andy Todd. I'll have to say Mark Lever, because even though people didn't think Mark was a good player, he did a good job and we had a good understanding. Tony Gallimore. I think I had one between Gary and Kev. So I'll have to say them too. Wayne Burnett. Phil Bonneman. On the left, Dave Gilbert. Tony Rees. Clyde Mendonca, they were the best team. I think we'd win the league with them now.
PlayStation or Xbox?
PlayStation.
Chicken nuggets or fish fingers?
Oh, fish fingers.
Books or movies?
Movies.
Tea or coffee?
Tea.
Winter or summer?
Summer.
Chinese or Indian?
Chinese.
Cardio or weights?
Weights.
iPhone or Android?
iPhone.
Fruit or veg?
Fruit.
Chocolate or sweets?
Chocolate.
Messi or Ronaldo?
Ronaldo.
Seaside or city?
Seaside.